So for today's tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to be making some panniers or panniers or however you pronounce it. If you want to do like period piece costumes. Now this book was recommended to me. It's called Corsets and Crinolines and it's by Norah Waugh. It has a ton of different patterns, like different period style corsets from different eras. It breaks it down like what they were made of and the history. It's a really cool book. I really recommend it if you want to get into doing period pieces. These are pretty much accurate to the time, and she also puts out diagrams if you want to copy it. So that's what I'm going to do today. Out of this book, I'm going to copy the panier pattern on page 48 of this book. What you're going to need is a cotton material, which I have this embroidered embossed like cotton. It's just scraps, but it'll work. And also I'm using for this part of the pattern, for this dark, for the dark lines here, I'm using poly boning, which you can find at Joann's. And then you'll need some ribbon also for your waistband to tie it off, and that's about it. So if you'll see in the diagram, she has like a key that shows like the measurement, so that way you can kind of translate this to an actual human size, which I did, and hopefully I think it's correct. It looks about right to me. So in the pattern, once you cut out this, you're gonna have like a split here. It says that this piece here needs to be pleated. It needs to be pleated down to 3 3/4 on each side. So you're gonna, you know, pleat this, fold it and pleat until this measures 3 3/4 and this part measures 3 3/4. And just for your reference, so you know what my measurements are here, there's gonna be 3 pieces to this piece, this pattern piece. There's this piece, and then there's gonna be a square piece and a weird dome-like shape, which you can see if you turn to page 48, if you buy this book, it has, oh, don't mind my marker here. It has these two pieces. So this is A, B, C, D corner, and this top part up here, the corner is C and D. So once you fold this like this, this part down here is what's gonna go underneath here. It's underneath, it's what's, so that lines up with that. And then this piece is this right here on the inside. So this piece A, B, C, D lines up with A, B, C, D. So just so you understand the placement of that, but I will do it obviously in the video, but I just wanted to show you as everything is flat. So the main piece, which is what I'll call it the main piece. The bottom I have measuring to 26 inches. And this slanted part here measures 17 and a half inches. And then up here, including the split, this is, it's about 19 inches. And then for the little square piece, and make sure with this one you cut out 2. So that's 2. And then this little square piece here, this is going to measure 8 1/2. Was it 8 1/2? So it's 8 1/2 by 9. Not quite a perfect square, almost a square, more like a rectangle. So it's 8 1/2 and 9 inches. And again, you're gonna cut 2 of those. And then with your weird little dome piece, again, look at it like this. Look at it like a little square, which measures, let's see if it's a square, 9 by 9. And then you just kind of cut out a little dome shape. That's a part of it. I eyeballed this, but if you want to do the square first and then maybe do another square and do a little even dome shape and then tape it to make this piece, you can totally do that. And again, you're going to want to cut two of those. And then as for my polyboning, these were white, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to T-stain everything. So I T-stained these first. And when you T-stain something, basically is you just boil water and you brew tea. And then when it cools down, you dye your fabric, basically. So whenever you do dyeing, you want to make sure that your fabric is all wet first. And then you immerse it in your T-stain or your dye or whatever you're dyeing your fabric with. So once I cut out all my pieces, then I'll go ahead and T-stain the white fabric. But for my, it is the same across. I cut out 21 inches. 21 inches for each of these. So basically, if you look at that one pattern on this in the book, it's gonna have the dark lines going across, which is basically where that's the placement for these, okay? So that's what that's gonna happen. So I'm gonna finish cutting out all my pieces, and then I'm gonna take them to my tea stain. I'll show you how I'm doing that, and then after that, we'll wash and dry, and then we'll go ahead and start assembling our panniers, okay? Thanks. Okay, so right now I have my tea boiling, but basically, as I was getting at right now when I was in my garage, once you cut out all your pieces, you wet them thoroughly so that all pieces are saturated and there's no dry spots. Because when you do dry spots, you run the risk of your fabric not dyeing evenly. So you might have darker spots or lighter spots here. And you know, if that's not intentional, like, it'll just look ugly. So this really, and that goes for anything. Same thing if you try and dye it all dry and just dunk it in, you're not gonna get an even saturation because it's dry. It has to be wet first. So wet all your pieces, make sure they're thoroughly dampened, wet, wring them out a little bit. And then once you take your tea bags out of your pot or whatever you're brewing them in, then just kind of like put them in there and like swish it around a little bit and let them soak, move them around. You really don't have to constantly stir. I mean, you could if you wanted to, but I've gotten fine results by just swirling it around a little bit at first for like 15 seconds and then just letting it soak and moving it around here and there while I do other stuff in the house. And then maybe after about 20 minutes, take them out, put them in your washing machine, run it on like a rinse and spin cycle, or you could wash them, rinse and spin will be fine though. And then after that, dry them, and then we can get started on the next part. Okay, so let's go ahead and start off. I already have one side made, and I'll show you guys in a moment. But let's go ahead and start off when we start doing the plating. Like I said in the other video, according to the pattern on the book, each side here has to be pleated back, has to be pleated, shrunk down to 3 3/4 inches. 3.75 if you like decimals. Anyways, so you really don't have to be too anal about the evenness of the pleating. Just shrink it down to that, you know. So right now it measures about 9 inches. So I'm just going to eyeball and pleat this way and then pin it. And then where is it? I've shrunk it down to about 7 inches. And then I'm just gonna evenly, what I do here, I'm gonna do here. So I'm just gonna pull this and bring it in a little bit and fold it. And then I'm gonna pin it. So now I'm at 5.5. And then I'll just take the center and I'll just kind of pull it in as much as I can. Let me just pull in. It's a little off, so I'll just pull in this part in the middle a little more. Let me pin that. Okay, now it's 3 3/4. So I'll do that here. Do that here. And then once we do that, we're going to get our poly boning strips that we already have pre-measured from before. And it's three equal sections on this pattern piece. One is right below your cutout right here, this V cutout, this slit in the middle. And then the other one is right at the bottom near the hem. And then you can place the other one in the middle, equal distance between the other two poly boning strips. So you'll sew those down. I would recommend a zipper foot, which would be the easiest, so that way you don't puncture the plastic, because you're not actually sewing the plastic down to the fabric. You sew like, just this tiny little, like if you pull it, you can pull some allowance away from the strip as you feel it. So you gotta kind of just follow the line that's already here, and you can sew it down pretty quick if you use a zipper foot. So you can do that. Yeah, that'll be the easiest. If not, you wanna just take your time with your regular foot and do it slowly, because sometimes when you're sewing on top of it with a regular straight foot or something, it might start like getting slippery on the thing, and then you could puncture the plastic, and if you're going really fast, you could break your needle. So you just wanna take your time there. So you'll put the three strips, and then once you're already there, then you're gonna fold this over, and you're gonna take your square piece, which I, for some reason, forgot to iron this one, but I ironed everything else. I don't know. Anyway, so you're gonna take your square piece, and you're going to sew it here and here. Do you see? You're gonna sew that, these two parts, and then on the bottom, as you can see here, then you fit in your little weird shape dome piece here. So let me go ahead and take you over here to the one that I finished, so you can check out how this is. Okay, so as you can see, this is what it looks like right now. I have my three pieces. I have the bottom one down here. It is a little loose. I'm gonna do some more reading and see if you're supposed to stuff this with anything. I don't think so. This is pretty good, the fullness right here. And then here's the slit. And then as you can see on the inside, that's that part. Now, so I do wanna mention here, see how I have these little squares covering the edges of my polyboning? You can do this, and I would recommend it, because a lot of times if you just sew it down, the polyboning can cut this fabric or above it when let's say you put your dress over this, because this is considered an undergarment. This can also cut the fabric of the dress if it rubs up against it, especially because a lot of time you'll cut the plastic when you're trimming it, and it'll still have a sharp edge. Even if you try and like smooth it out in a dome shape at the end, it still might cut it. So I just get a little piece of fabric, whatever, and I just cover it like this. Here I had some leftover vinyl from a scrap piece, and I just used it to cover that. And that'll just keep it, like I said, from snagging on the dress you intend to put over this undergarment, or the fabric itself that you use to make the pannier. So, you know, you can, so do that. And if you looked at a lot of special occasion garments, they do that a lot too. They will put a little mesh to cover the edge or the ends of those poly bonings. But this is what it looks like. And then at the end, we'll fold these down for a tunnel, and then we'll go ahead and put some ribbon through it. And then that's how you tie it onto yourself, you know, in the front. But yeah, let me keep sewing the other half and we'll get through this. Okay, so this is how I'm doing it since I don't have a zipper foot. Right now I'm using a clear embroidery foot. And what's nice about that is that the embroidery foot that I have, see those three orange lines? It helps as a guidance to keep things straight and keep things centered.
So how, if you have this type of foot, here's my tip on using it. I switched my needle to the left side, to the left position. And I already have that little vinyl piece that I was mentioning how to use it. So basically with this little orange line, I'm going to align it with the stitch, the original stitch of the poly boning. Okay, so I set my foot down and I have it lined up right now. And then I'm just going to keep my eye on the orange line and have it aligned with this stitch the whole time. See, and I'm not getting the plastic, I'm only getting fabric. And if it starts feeling like it's warping, see how it kind of warped right there? I'll just pull out my needle, straighten it out a bit, and then I will continue with what I'm doing. And I'm also using a large stitch width on this one, but you could use a small one. I just want to do this quick, and it'll be fine with a large stitch too. So I'm just going along with it. All right, so I'm basically nearing the end to my panniers. So I finished putting together the other, which one was it? This side, the other side, everything that the first. All the steps that I showed you with the first side that I did. And then once you are ready to string the ribbon through, just take the raw edge that you had, fold it down about 3/4 of an inch or an inch, depending how thick your ribbon or string you're gonna use to feed it through. So see here how I fold it, slow it down. It doesn't have to be super perfect. I mean, this is a foundation garment. Just have it sewn together. That way it holds up for the actual dress that you will be wearing over it. So what I did now, with the usual when you string stuff through, I got my safety pin, put it through here. And I put it through, so that way you won't get confused. Look at the way mine is. I fed it through this one first, and then back around this. And then in the back of this one, I fed it through, and now I just have to feed it through this last part right here, and then they'll be done. So that's just what I'm doing right now, but that's pretty much it. If you're confused at all or anything about this and want to know more about the book, I'll have its, that ISBN number or whatever. I'll put that in the description box. And of course, if you have any questions, you know, feel free to ask me. I'm not a professional teacher at this stuff at all, so if anything I did or I missed a step and it threw you off, please ask me. I answer back right away. I'm really cool about that, so just let me know. Have fun making this. All right, bye.